If you are visiting our channel for the first time, please subscribe first to get the basic and advanced maths concepts.
Today we are going to learn that how you can differentiate one function with respect to the other. Up till now we have seen the functions like dy dx of x square or the function like dy dx of cos of x or dy dx of natural log of x. So, in all these functions, what is common? The common thing is this dx, where you are going to where you use to differentiate these functions with respect to x. So you differentiate this function with respect to x, but keep one thing in mind that this x is also in these functions. So it was easier for you to differentiate such functions. But what if that differentiate a function like x square with respect to cos of x, then how you will do that? Or if I say that differentiate a function like natural log of x square plus 3. So you have to differentiate the given function, that is x square plus 3, with respect to natural log of x. And here you have to differentiate the function x square with respect to this cos of x. So the difference between them is that the function or with respect that in you are differentiating one function with respect to the others. So you have two functions in it. One function is this and the other function is this. While in the previous cases we have seen that there is only a one function and the other is the variable that is involving in that function. So today we are going to learn this, that how you can differentiate such functions. So let's start with the example. I'll take the simplest example first, then we will move towards the complex ones. So if I ask to differentiate x square plus 2x with respect to x4. So we have two functions here. Function number 1 is this and function number 2 is this. So here comes the concept of the chain rule. So we have to use the concept of chain rule while differentiating the two functions, one function with respect to the other. So in such a case, what you have to do? Your step number 1 is substitution. How? Let's see. You have to substitute the variables instead of these functions. So I'll say let y is equals to x square plus 2x and u is equals to x4. This is the step number 1. Then we have the step number 2, where we have to find the derivatives of both the functions with respect to the variables involved. So it means we have to differentiate this function with respect to x and we have to differentiate this function with respect to x as well. So let's differentiate these functions as, first we will differentiate the y as dy by dx is equals to d by dx of x square plus 2x. So its derivative will be, by using the power rule, the derivative of x square will be 2x and the derivative of 2x will be 2. As the 2 is a constant, we'll take 2 common and the derivative of x is 1. So 2x plus 2 is the derivative of the first function. Then we have to find the derivative of the other function as well, that is du by dx. So d by dx of what? This x4. So x4, so the derivative of x4 is 4x cube. That is according to the power rule, you have to find its derivative. So in second step, you have found the derivative of the two functions. Now what is the third step? The third step is just to put these derivatives into the chain rule. Use chain rule. So what is the chain rule? As here, keep this in mind. Normally we came across the chain rule, that is dy by dx is equal to d. Previously we have seen the chain rule is like dy by dx is equals to dy by du dot du by dx. But here there is something different. How? Let's see. Here we have to find the derivative of y, that is this y, with respect to this. So it means anything that is in with respect to, you have to put it into the denominator. So I'll write dy by du. Keep this in mind. We will not write dx here. as normally we used to do in the chain rule. So dy by du, we will form the equation as dy by dx, that is this one, dot dx by du. Keep this in mind. It will not be this one du by dx. It will be dx by du, because by cancelling these dx and dx, we will get back the dy by du. So we have to put these values and keep this mind. We have to invert this value in order to put it into the given chain rule. You have to take 1 over 4x cube rather than 4x cube. So let's put these values. So dy by dx is equals to 2x plus 2. So 2x plus 2 and du by dx, and the dx by du is 1 divided by 4x cube. So the answer will be 2x plus 2 divided by 4x cube. So this is the derivative of x squared plus 2x with respect to x4. So these are the just three steps that you are required to find the derivative of one function with respect to the other. Let's have one more example for your concept. Most of the time we get confused with some functions written in such a way that how you will differentiate such horrible functions. But there is nothing to worry about. Let's have one more example. If you came across the function as d by d of cos 4x, and you have to derivate the function, which that is sine square x, and how you will find its derivative. Now no need to get confused with the functions like this. Now just try to understand it. What is this? This is basically the function with respect to what you are going to derivate this function sine square x. As we normally see that d by, we have got d over dx. So other than x, we have got a function here. So in this question, we have two functions. This is function number one, and this is function number two. So we have to use a chain rule in order to find its derivative. So what is the step number one? So step number one is, as we have already seen, substitution. You have to substitute some variable instead of the given functions. So let's do the substitution. Y is equals to sine square x, and u is equals to cos of 4x. This is the step number one. Now let's see what is the step number two. If you do something in by step by step, then it will be easier for you to understand and keep in your mind that how to solve some certain function. Find derivative with respect to x. This x and this x. The functions are involving, or you can say derivative with respect to the variables involved in the function. So we will derivate the function first. We will derivate it, find the derivative of y is equal to sine x. dy by dx is equals to d by dx of sine square x. So we will find its derivative as, so sine square x means d by dx of sine of x whole square. So its derivative will be 2 into sine x. And then we have to find the derivative of the sine x again, that is like this. So what we will get? You get 2 sine x cos x. So then we have to find the derivative of u function, du by dx. This is the u function. So d by dx of cos 4x. So it means d by dx of cos x whole 4. So we have to find its derivative as 4. By using the power rule, move the power on the side and subtract 1 from the power, so it will become 3. And then you have to find the derivative of the cos x. So it will become 4 cos x whole cube minus sine x. So these are the derivatives of the two functions. Now what is the step 3? Step 3 is the last step of this example. So I'll write the step 3 here. So step 3 is use chain rule. Find the derivative. So we have to use the chain rule. First I'll write the formula of chain rule here. As we have to find the derivative this y with respect to this u, so it means I have to write dy by du. You are differentiating y, that is sine square x, with respect to u, that is cos 4x. So the formula will become dy by dx dot dx by du. So we have to put back the values from here and from here. So what we have got, dy by du is equals to, dy by dx is 2 sin x cos x, and dx by du is what? As this is du by dx, so we have to take its invert the so we have to take the reciprocal of this answer, that is 1 divided by 4 cos x whole cube minus sin x, in order to put it into the given chain rule formula, because the given the derivative is actually du by dx, but what is required here is dx by du. So we'll write it in the denominator as minus 4 cos x whole cube into sin x. Simplify it as like this, it will be cancelled out, and cos x and 1 cos will be cancelled out, and what we will get is dy by du is equals to 1 divided by minus 2 cos x whole square. So this is the derivative of the given function, that is sin square x with respect to cos 4 of x. So whenever you came across the functions like this, you have to use the chain rule in such a way that I have told you in just 3 steps. So that's all from today's lecture. Hope so it will help you a lot. Thank you.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe our channel math.com for more updates. Thank you.